Dr. Bob Weber from Kansas State University is joining me today. He was one of the speakers at the SDSU Extension Genetic Seed Stock Symposium. Dr. Weber is an extension beef cow-calf specialist at K-State, and he talked about EPDs and indexes during his presentation. So I'm going to ask him to explain a little bit more about what he told the producers that were here at the session today. So, Dr. Weber, producers have used EPDs for many years in cattle selection. Now we hear of the terminology indexes. Can you explain what indexes is?
Yeah, sure, Lynn. A selection index really is just a way of weighting our existing EPDs to provide a single value that producers can use in selection to sort of simplify their selection decisions and put appropriate weight on traits that have significant economic importance to their production system.
So then more specifically, how can indexes be used in cattle selection?
Sure. So one of the strategies is really to try and align our selection system and the traits that we use in selection with our marketing outcomes or our marketing endpoints. And so one of the things that we encourage producers to do as they think about selection, and certainly multiple trait selection has been really difficult for producers to do over time because we have a large suite of EPDs available across a broad range of traits, and some of those may not have specific economic importance at certain endpoints in our system. And so the indexes are constructed with an endpoint in mind, typically, so maybe a weaning endpoint or a carcass endpoint, and then appropriately weight those traits into a single value. And so producers should use an index that's aligned with their endpoint, and then they use it just like an EPD. So it expresses the relative difference between bulls for a particular trait or a particular index outcome in dollar terms. And so it's in a really approachable sort of metric in terms of dollars, and they'd use it just like any other tool and select for the animals that excel in that particular index, making sure it's again aligned to their market endpoint.
Well, and you use the terminology economic relevant traits, and that's maybe more in the development of indexes that you do as a geneticist. But can you explain how that connection is with indexes and why it's important that we're looking at the ones with economic relevant traits?
Sure, that's a great observation that, you know, in our suite of EPDs, we have traits that are directly, in some cases, connected to a cost or revenue in our production system, and those are ERTs. So it's an economically relevant trait is one that either incurs cost or generates revenue in our production system. We have other traits then that are genetically related to those potentially through a genetic correlation, and those are called indicator traits. They provide some information about an ERT, but not all of the information. And so the beauty of the index method is that it uses both of those sets of traits to gather as much information associated with differences in profit as we can in our production system and summarize that into a single value for selection.
Okay, so as producers, especially seed stock producers, as they move to using and understanding indexes more, how can they work with their commercial bull buyers and commercial cattlemen to help understand what the importance of indexes are?
Yeah, seed stock producers play a real key role in our education system in the United States in that they provide a lot of information to their commercial bull customers, commercial bull customers look to those seed stock producers as sources of good scientifically based information. And so as seed stock producers become more educated and learn more about indexes and adopt those in some cases in their own selection system, they need to provide some of that training and education to their clients and particularly help sort out sort of what their breeding objective is, so have their commercial customers define what it is they do in terms of maybe replacement heifer development, how they sell their calves, whether at weaning time or on the rail, and help them pick which selection index is the appropriate one to use in their system and sort of coach them through that process a little bit. I think that does a couple things. Obviously, it builds confidence in the commercial producers, but it also provides a key relationship building opportunity between the seed stock producer and their commercial client to get to know more about their operation and help them do a better job selecting seed stock that really do meet their selection objectives.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Bob Weber from Kansas State University, for being one of our speakers today and explaining us better about EPDs and indexes. For more information about the program, you can go to www.igrow.org.